Research Design Lab.
Hi. Now I'm doing the project with a demo on the project. Like this indoor navigation. So we are using Edger from microcontroller as Nano2 with the project. So the program for the Edger program is written in the key version 3. So now we will create a project. Open the key in Nano2 version 3. So now we have to create the project. So here I have to go to project and then click on new microvision project. So now we have to create a folder now to save all the files. So I am going to select here desktop and here I am creating a folder that is LPX. So I am inside the folder and just saving a file called px and you just click on the save button. So now here it will show the database. So here we have to select here add month. So here we have to select the add month and just scroll down. So here we will find 8089SY2, the controller which we are using here. You select the controller and then click on OK. So here we can see the target and the source group one. So now to write the program now, you have to go to file and click on new. So here you will get a text editor. So I have got a copy of code. So I am just saving the program now. So I just copied the program. Okay. So after this you have to go to file here and just click on save as. So now you just give a name, any name. So again I am going to give something like ex1 and we have to give the extension here. So we have to give dot C. Click on save. So now the color of the header files and some values, hexadecimal values is going to change after creating a C file. So now we have to go to target here. Just right click on the target. So here we can see some of the options here. So we have to select here options for target 1. So here the ISO is mentioned as 33 here, but here we are using 11.0592 MHz crystal. So we have to change the value for this 11.0592. Next we have to go to your output option. Click on output option and then we have to select here create X file and then click on OK. So now we have again right click on source group 1 and again we can find the option here called add files to group. Add files to group. So just click on that. Now it will show the folder which you have created which ends up with .c file. Just click on that and click on add. So once you click on add, just click on again close because here in the source group 1 the tx1 will be added. So it has compiled successfully and there is no zero errors and zero warnings. So now we go through the program. For the 8051 we have to define that include h51.h and hash include string.h. We have to use the ASP functions. Here in the transmitter side I have taken 3 digital pins. That is LOC1 for 2.0 and LOC2 for the pin number 2.1 and LOC3 for pin number 2.2.
Thank you.
Using these 3 digital pins, I am just transmitting the data through LEDs. So whereas these three LED panels are connected to the pin number 2.0, 2.1 and 2.2. Whereas here the transmit by function is to transmit the data through the serial. And coming to the wide line function, we have a demo register here. So we have given 0x20 for the demo register. So this is a demo register, which is an 8-bit register. So here, so whereas the demo register is divided for the two timers, for two timer operation. Whereas this is having timer 0 and the timer 1. Whereas here, the timer 0 is a 13-bit timer and timer 1 is a 16-bit timer. Here we are using, for the serial communication, we are using 16-bit timer mode. So we are making use of timer 1 here. Coming to the timer 1. So here there is an M1 and M0, these are mode selection bits, and then we have a C bar T, which is a counter or timer mode, and next we have a gate. So this is a gate control bit. So here we will make use of C bar and T and mode 1, mode 0, and timer 0 will be kept all zeros. So coming to mode. Here we have M1 and M0, which we are selecting as 00, which is a mode 0, which operates at 30-bit timer mode. If we are giving 01, which operates as a 16-bit timer mode, nothing but 8-bit operation for transmitting and 8-bit operation for receiving. And next we have 10, which is an 8-bit auto reload mode, and 11 is of split timer mode. So here we use the mode 1 in our for the serial communication, which is in the timer 1. So we need to make use of timer here. So we have to give C bar T to be 0. Now to make for the timer operation, so gate should be 0 and C bar T should be 0, and M1 should be given as 1 and M0 is given as 0, that is not operate in an 8-bit auto reload mode, and rest of the bits will be given as 0. So now the data becomes 0010 and 0000, which is nothing but 20 we have to load to the TMOD register. So next we have the TH1. Whereas TH1 register is a timer register, we have to feed 0xFT. 0xFT is nothing but a baud rate for the controller. So 0xFT in terms of hexadecimal indicates 9600 baud rate. So next we have SCON register here, which is nothing but a serial control register. So coming to serial control register, so here this is also an 8-bit register. So here first we have receive interrupt, and second we have transmit interrupt, and here third bit is RP8, and next we have PN8, and the fifth one is receive enable, and fourth one is mode serial mode 2, and 6th bit is serial mode 1 and 7th bit is serial mode 0. So here the TA and RI indicates whether TA is nothing but the transmit interrupt and RI is nothing but the receive interrupt. So TI indicates that the data is being transmitted. Whenever the data is transmitted, here the TA register becomes high, and next whenever the data is being received, the receive interrupt, nothing but the response register of 0th bit, becomes high. So we have loaded here response register with 0xF0, and coming to the PCON register. So here the PCON register will be used for doubling the baud rates. So now looking into picon register. So here I have got a picon register. So this is an 8 bit register. So in the 8 bit I have got an SMOD. So SMOD is the register we use not to double the baud rate. So we have to put this 8th pin high so that the baud rates are going to be doubled. So the data to be fed to this register will be 0, 0, 0 and 0 and then 0, 0, 0 and the 7th bit will be 1. So now it becomes 80 with the picon register. There are CR1 is a timer register. We have to give the TR1 is equal to 1. So now to start the timer. So now the initial setup is done. So we are going to move to the while 1. So we have used the while 1 so that whatever the program we have written that will be executed several times. So initially I have a delay function here. So this will produce me approximately of 15 milliseconds delay. And next I have a 3 variables which are given with the digital pins which are connected to 3 LED panels. Here initially the LOC variable is equal to 0. Nothing but the data will be transmitted through the first panel and rest of the two panels will be kept high, nothing but they will be in ideal state. And I have got some small delay here. And next I have got a for loop of looping 3 times through the transmit rate function, nothing but through the first LED panel I am going to send A 3 times. And again I have got some delays for delay functions. And again after sending A 3 times I am making the second digital pin to be low and other 2 digital pins to be high. So now through the second LED panel I am just transmitting B. That is done 3 times using the for loop. And then I have got a delay. And again I have taken the 3 digital pins. Now the first 2 digital pins are high and the third digital pin is low. So now the data is going to transmit to the third digital pin, nothing but the third LED panel. That I am transmitting here is C. In the for loop it is of 3 times. So now 3 times the C is being transmitted. And again I have got the delay, some delay. And again the same way the loop is going to repeat several times. So now everywhere we see the transmit function, transmit wave function. Now moving to the transmit wave function now. Here I got a transmit wave function in this. So if I want to transmit an EA, so I am going to pass the character through this transmit wave function. So I have got here unsigned char and byte. So after receiving the byte through this function, there is a register called SBUF register which is a serial buffer register. So the data will be stored into serial buffer register. After loading the data to the serial buffer register, we have to check for the TI flag which is nothing but transmit interrupt. So once the data is being transmitted, so the TI variable set to be high. So once data is transmitted, this while loop becomes false so that data being transmitted and I am going to make TI variable to be 0. Now we will go to the receiving program. Again open the key microvision. So now again we have to follow same steps what we have done for the transmitting program. So we have to go to the project and create new project. So again we have to select a folder. So again I am selecting here LRX. So just open the folder and save it. Save and give the name. So I give one as an RX and click on the save button. So again click show the. So here just select admin. So in this 8089S52. So I have selected 8089S52. Just click on OK. So it will ask. So just code to project folder. So just click on no. So now we'll get the target underscore source group. So now go to file and click on view. So a text editor will be appeared here. So again, I'm going to copy the receiving program now. So now I've got the receiving program. So now first we have to group. So first we'll save the file. So just click on the save as button. So we'll go to file and click on save as. So now it will show the same folder. So just click on, so just give the name rx.c and click on save. So now it will be saved as C program. So now we just go to the target and right click on the target. So just click on the options for target 1. So again change the crystal 11.0592. And again go to the output. Here click on the create X file and click on OK. Again now we have to go to the source group 1 and right click on that. So here we have to select add files to the group source group 1. So again the RxC file will be generated. Just click on the select the RxC file and again click on add. So it will be added in the source group 1. Now click on. Now here the C file is being added. So go to file and click save. So now we will build the program. So here we are showing 0 errors and 0 warnings. So after this, well, I have created the LRX. So once I create the project, so this much of files are going to be there. So here it has been created the X file. This X file we have to load into the IC. So now we'll go through the hardware connections which I written in the program also. Now I'm going to explain once the receiving program. So whereas the receiving program here is having the three pins which I defined for the voice playback. The pin number is port 2.0 and the port 2.1 and port 2.2. Also have taken the port 1.0 here for the vibration sensor. And next, coming to the wide line, I have defined the D-mode register and I have given this worded as 0xFB. So for, that is for the TH1 register, and again S1 register as 0x50 and next P1 register as 0x80, which is similar to the transmitting side. So here we have defined 9600 baud rate using an PCON register. We have to double the baud rate. So 9600 baud rate will be doubled into 1009200. Next, here coming to the while one, here I have some delay function, small delay function, and then there is a function called URT is equal to SCI receive byte. We have a receive byte function where the data is being received through the serially using a serial buffer register, and after receiving the data, this function will return the serial data to the UART RD variable. So later we are going to check the variable is A, then we are going to play a voice, that is nothing but here the pins which we are using, the port 2.0, port number 2.1 and pin number 2.2. So all the pins are driven pull down, nothing but the voice playback is going to work in the pull down mode. So we have to put initially all the three pins to be high. So the port 2 is kept 0xff, nothing but all the pins high, and the port 1 is kept 00, where for the port 1.0 we have connected an vibrator sensor. So now initially if A is received to the serial, so we have to play a voice. So I think we have to play a first voice. So I am making LOC 1 is equal to 0, which is port 2.0 to 0, and LOC 2 is equal to 1 and LOC 3 is equal to 1. nothing but it is going to play the first voice indicating the location A. And next, I am going to make the vibrating motor to be on. And after some delay, again I am going to make the port 2 pin, port 2 is equal to 0 except the nothing but it puts all the pins as ones as of the initial state. And again, the vibrator motor to the 0. And again, there is some small delays here, beta functions. And again, I am going to make the receive interrupt nothing but RI register to 0. And again, we have else if. So, if we are receiving B through the serial function, so we are going to compare. If it is B, then I am going to make the motor again I. And so we have to play the second voice now. So LOC is equal to 1. So whereas the LOC 1 will be 1, and LOC 2 is equal to 0, and LOC 3 will be 1. And there is some small delay here. Again, I am going to make the port to be high as of the insert state. And again, VAP is equal to 0. Again, nothing but I am going to off the motor after some delay. And after this, I am going to give some small delays again. Again, we have an else if. This is for the location C. So, UART is equal to 1, nothing but the receiving byte gives C through serial. Again, I am going to make the motor equal to 1, nothing but it, motor is going to rotate. And again, now I need to play the third voice, which is location C. So, now I need to put LOC is equal to 1 and LOC 2 is equal to 1. Now, LOC 3 should be 0 now. And again, I am going to give some small delay. And again, P2, nothing but the port 2 again remains its same state, which is nothing but all the pins to be high. And again, I am going to off the vibrator motor. So, which is nothing but a voice is going to play for some time and motor is going to rotate for some time. Again, they are going to return to the normal state, nothing but all the pins to be off. So now coming to the SCI receive byte function. This is the function receives the data through the serial. So here first we'll have a while loop here. While RI is not equal to 1. Whereas RI is nothing but a receive interrupt. So we have to monitor here the receive interrupt variable. So if any data is being received through the receive interrupt, the RI register becomes high. Nothing but it comes out of this while loop till receiving receiving RI. If the RI variable is not gone, nothing but the data is not being received and it will be looping in the while loop. So after receiving the data, so we need to copy the data from SCOP register to a byte variable. And again I am going to make the receive interrupt equal to 0, and then I am going to return the byte. So wherever we are calling this SCI receive byte function, it comes inside this function. If the data has been received, it just returns the byte of data which is received through the library receiver. Now we will go through the hardware, how the interfacing is done and how the connections are being made. Here we have got the transmitter and the receiver, whereas I have given the power supply through the adapter here. So whereas we have got the three LED panels, whereas these three LED panels require more current. So I have driven this LED panel through an 2 amps 12 volt adapter, and again for the power supply for the controller is given with another adapter in the transmitter side. And again in the receiver side, for this 8051 controller board, we have got a 12 volts transformer, sorry, 12 volts adapter. So we just power on the circuit. So once the circuit is being powered on, so we have to reset the controller once in the transmitter on the receiver side. So now according to the program, the data is being transmitted continuously through the LED panels. So now we'll go through the transmitter section. So here, coming to the connections, we have used port number 2.0 and 2.1 and 2.2 in the program. So those three pins, digital pins, I have connected to an OR gate driver here. Also, the data we are transmitting through the serial, that will be given. So here the serial pin is 3.1 is a transmitter in the 8051. So that is connected to the RX pin of Li-Fi transmitter. And we can see here the MOSFET connection. So we need to operate the three lights sources. So this input pin of this MOSFET I have taken and I have connected to a driver which is an OR gate driver. So using a one pin and three digital pins, we are controlling the three lights, nothing but we are transmitting the data through three lights. That I am going to show drawing a circuit of the OR gate driver. So we have got here TX, this is nothing but we have a connection from the Li-Fi transmitter. So this wire, so instead of MOSFET we need to use an OR gate driver here. So for the OR gates I have connected a TX as an one input, and we have got the three digital pins. Those three digital pins I have connected an second input for the three OR gates. So next, the output of these three OR gates are connected to a MOSFET here. Here the MOSFET I am using is IRF3205. So this has got a gate, drain and the source. The output of OR gate will be connected to a gate which is an input to the MOSFET, and we have got the drain. So whereas for the drain we have to connect a ground of LED panel, because the LED panel is going to take a 12 volt power supply. So we can't operate the LED panel through the controller. So we are driving the LED panel through using the ground. So we have got an external power supply here. The 12 volt of this external power supply will be directly connected to all the three LED panels, and the ground of this LED panel will be connected to the drain of the three MOSFETs. So whenever we get the high pulse from this OR gate, the LED panels are going to become off and then on, nothing but the drain and the source are going to connect and then disconnect. So using this principle, making the light off and on, nothing but the time duration of this off and on. So we are converting again the same data using some timers in the receiver side, and we are converting the flickering time in terms of bits in the receiver side, and we are creating a byte in the receiver side. So now coming to this, so for example, now in the program I am going to make the LOC 1 is equal to 1, see 1 is equal to 0, and then LOC 2 is equal to 0 is equal to 1 in order to transmit the first byte, LOC 3 equal to 1. So now for example, if you have an 8-bit data like 10101111, so now initially LOC is equal to 0, nothing but the data for each bits is going to add up with 0. So whatever the data here through the TX which is incoming will be transmitted through the LED. And now coming to LOC 2 which is having 1, so now if we are adding with 1, so 1 plus 1 will remain 1, and if you add with a 0 and again it will remain 1. So the second LED panel will be constantly become on state. And coming to LOC 3, this LED panel will also be in continuous on state. So if we are keeping LOC 1 is equal to 0, nothing but this OR gate is going to add the data with the TX, and it will transmit through the LED panel 1, and another two LED panels will be there in continuous high state, and they will be transmitting continuously once. So again, if you want to transmit the data through LED 2, so now we have to put LOC 1 is equal to 1 and LOC 2 is equal to 0 and LOC 3 is equal to 1. So now this LOC 1 is equal to 1, nothing but the whatever the data in the TX
which will be added with the 1. All the data, whenever we add it with the zeros and ones, we remain, the data will be remaining as 1. So LED panel will become continuous high, and again LOC 2 is equal to 0. If we add the data with the 0, the data will be in the TX will remain same. So LED gets flickered and it will transmit the zeros and ones to the receiver side, and LOC 3 will become in the I state. Same way we are going to transmit the data through the LED panels. Here now we have got the receiver section. So in this we have got a LiPo receiver. So if we hold a LED panel on this, so this is going to receive the data, and again through this board the data will be transmitted to the, through the TX pin here. So this TX pin is connected to the RX pin of the 8051, which is an pin number 3.0. and again, so once the byte A is received, so we have to make some voice to be played. So we need to have 3 digital pins. So the digital pins which I have taken is 2.0, 2.1 and the 2.2, and these 3 pins are connected to a voice playback here. And then I have pin number 1.0 here. So this is connected to a vibrator motor. Also that has got a 5 volt underground. So we will go for the demo now. Here I have gotten a first LED panel, and this is my second LED panel, and this is my third LED panel. So I am going to take the first LED panel now, and I am going to hold on the receiver. So now displaying location A. Also just look into this, the motor is going to run. So now I am going to hold the second LED panel on the receiver. So I can hear the location B now. Even the motor is going running. So we'll go for the third LED panel. So now it is playing location C. Then the motor is running in the location C as well. So next we'll go through the LiFi transmitter on the receiver, and for the next I'm going to explain how these potentiometers are going to be set when we use the lights sources. Now we'll see how to configure the LiFi modules. Here I have got a LiFi transmitter, and here we have a LiFi receiver. So initially, in order to configure the LiFi modules, here there is a jumper here. We have to connect the jumper into configuration mode. So anyhow, here I don't have MOSFETs. So because this connection I am driving through 3 MOSFETs. So once I keep the jumper to the configuration side, all the LED panels will be transmitting you initially. So now coming to the receiver side, I am going to reset all the potentiometers. So we will rotate the potentiometer to the left completely. So now I am going to remove the transmitter connection, nothing but if you hold the panel on this, so the data will be received and it will be transmitted again through this TX pin. So now I just removed the connection from the TX now. So whatever the, so in order to configure it, I am connecting an FT232 to my PC. So this is a serial converter through which I can get an RX and TX pin and the ground. So let me do the connections. So I am taking 2 patch cards here. So first I will take a ground connection. So here I am connecting ground to ground, and here I have got a TX pin. So this transmitting pin I have to connect it to the receiving pin of FT232. So now in order to see the received data, so I have got a hyperterminal software. So here I am using a teraterm. So just click on teraterm. So here select the C wave option. So later it will show the COM port where the serial FT232 is being installed. So now just click on OK. So here it will show 9600 baud rate. So just select the setup and go to here the serial port. So if you go to the serial port here, it will show the baud rates. Just change the baud rate to 19200 and just click on OK. So now here the receiver side as well. So now I'm just taking one every panel. So here coming to the receiver side. So here when here we have to put the jumper into the configuration mode. So now first we click on the reset here. There is a reset button here. Just click on the reset. So once you reset here, we can see resetdesignlab.com. So now we have to hold LED panel on this. Now we have to adjust. So just rotate the first potentiometer little and then the second potentiometer as well. So now, okay, we'll change the configuration to the run mode in the receiver side and let's rotate the potentiometers now. So again, I'm just resetting the potentiometers. We'll just move the first potentiometer in some 30 degree angle. So it is just receiving some U and again, I'm going to rotate the second potentiometer a little, nothing but in the 30 degree towards right. So now it is reading U but little slowly. So again I want to increase the first potentiometer. So now data transmitting become little fast even I am not getting any jump values in the serial monitor here when it is receiving U properly. So now all the data is being received. So again we need to reconfigure the transmitter here. We have to change the transmitter settings from configuration to run mode and even the receiver is already set to the run mode. So let me just open again, let me just close and open again. So now again click on the serial, just select the COM port, click on OK. So again I have to select the serial port again. So it should be 19200 baud rate. Just click on OK. So now if I just hold the LED panel on this, so whereas this is the third LED panel, it is just receiving as C. The same data we are just looking through the serial port now, nothing but using an FT232. So I can listen location A if I just hold the LED panel on this because it is receiving A. So now, yeah, now I can listen C because it is receiving C. So now, yeah, now it is saying location B, nothing but receiving B.